My name's Christian Tom. I'm the publisher at NowThis and The Dodo, which are two of the four media brands inside of Group Nine. Before the formation of Group Nine, I had been leading sales at NowThis. Before that, I was at Twitter and at YouTube. So when you think about kind of my overlapping Venn diagram of the video from YouTube and some of the social platforms from your time at Twitter, NowThis and the formation of Group Nine is a really nice kind of culmination of the various pieces coming together.
I'm Adam Shlachter. I, like Christian, did not work in the social media space. I worked in the agency space for the past 19 years. And about 4 months ago, I decided it was time for a change, and I wanted to do something different, and I wanted to work in a place where I could learn, and I could teach, and I could help create, and I could help solve problems, and do something different. Because for any of you guys that have worked at the agency space, or you're in the agency space, you know it's a challenge right now. And you know it's hard to navigate this incredibly complex landscape, and I thought I might be able to help everyone figure out by coming over to Group 9 helping with our positioning and our strategy and our partnerships and new ways of telling stories. And to me, it was important to do something that had real meaning and purpose behind it in this space. And if you know our content, I'm sure many of you guys have seen it, it's really the sort of essence of everything that we do. But I have an 8-year-old daughter who asked, "Wait, what are you doing? Why did you change offices?" And I took her to work the other day. And she was very confused because she was like, "Where are all the offices?" Because it's just rows and rows of desks. Agencies have it a little bit differently than some publishers and startups. And then she said, "Why are there animals in the office? Like, how do people bring dogs to?" I'm like, "Well, we create pet content." And she said, "What does that mean?" And eventually I just showed it to her. And she's seen some of the videos. She's seen them on Instagram. She's seen them on Facebook. She loves the stories. And she's 8. She doesn't watch TV. She doesn't watch in the traditional sense. She doesn't actually have a device or a social account. It's like she's too young for it. But through the lens that we've provided, she understands what we do in this world. And she doesn't see it as advertising. She doesn't see it as editorial or as news. She just sees it as content, as information, as education, and as something that she knows how to consume. She knows what to expect. I still couldn't explain it to her in words, but she got it when I showed her the videos.
I think a lot of what NowThis and The Dodo, Thrillist, and Secret were founded on is this idea that, guys, the norms of what's socially acceptable have forever changed. I think you're reading ahead of me, but this is a lot of feels so right to me. There's a guy in this coffee shop sitting at a table, not on his phone, and not on a laptop, just drinking coffee like a psychopath. And how weird is it now today to go to a coffee shop and see somebody just doing the thing for which the actual place is named? We're all going to be flying home, I assume, if the snow lets up sometime tomorrow or maybe later this week. But I was struck by this image. This is a New Yorker cover from a 2006 New Yorker magazine. And what's crazy is if you look at the picture of the waiting room or the gate waiting area, everybody is reading books. And I guarantee you when you fly out of Salt Lake City tomorrow, no one will be reading books. And I think what this is trying to kind of demonstrate is that when people are in fact shifting their behaviors and where they consume content and how they can consume content, it is increasingly going to mobile, and inside of mobile, it's increasingly going to social platforms. And so, at NowThis, at Thrillist, at The Dodo, at Secret, at Group 9, we see enormous, enormous consumption of video content specifically on social platforms. So a bit of an interactive question here. By show of hands, when you think about Group 9 and the four media kind of brands that we have underneath our portfolio, every single minute, who would venture that we are seeing 150 views? 15,000? No votes, okay.
What, two votes?
Oh, two, sorry, 150,000. Okay, a lot. 1.5 billion. Okay, a few more.
Yeah.
Very optimistic.
But 1.5 billion would be great.
That would be awesome.
Our valuation would be through the roof. But it's 150,000, which 150,000 views a minute that we are processing every single day. 38 million people every single day spending time with our brands to the tune of 100 million engagements every single day. It's a habit. And it's a habit because we have a trusted relationship with these audiences, who are largely younger audiences, 80% of people in their 20s we reach. Or if you looked at it on a millennial 18 to 35 basis, it's about 73% of that audience, about two-thirds of adults in the US. It's largely everyone. And what's interesting about it is, every single time we see them, every single time we have an interaction with them, we learn something new. What they like, what they have a comment about, an opinion, what they want to share, did they receive it from someone, so therefore it was a trusted source that was sending them something they're going to spend time with, so we can understand what they want to see next, where they want to see it next, what mindset it might be in, what their next moment of receptivity is going to be, that we should find a time and a place to tell them a story or to continue the story that we're telling them. And you know these brands because you see them in your feeds. Show of hands, who was an early subscriber to Thrillist back in the day? Everyone. Now this is probably the most popular and number one social news brand with a lowercase n across the distributed web. The Dodo is the number one brand on Facebook. And it's all about animals, animal people, the good that animals do in society. You can't watch some of the videos without a box of tissues nearby because it does give you some hope in this world. And Seeker, which is our fourth brand and came to us through our partnership with Discovery Communications, just relaunches all about science and technology and sort of where we're going in society and the future of things like STEM and how the next generation of engineers, maybe my 8-year-old, hopefully, that would be really cool, could solve the world's problems and kind of take us to where we're going next. But we like to say it's content for somebody. It's not for everybody. There's a purpose behind it. And let us show you a sizzle. And maybe you've heard this song 5 or 6 times in the past 2 days, so let's see.
Dude. Everything's going to be different.
Hell no place to go.
What can you not love about him?
Darling, hell no place to go.
This is going to be fun.
This is really amazing.
Goodbye, baby. Is this where we get to the hope?
Yes, I'm going.
Down the road I go.
And away we go.
Down the road I go.
Darling.
Each one of these lives is going to touch another life and another and another.
That is what a force of nature is.
Go out there, take a picture, send it on the internet, carry on.
We love the line.
So now this, you may have seen it now, this video in your Facebook feed before, on Instagram, on Snapchat, Discover, on Twitter. We have actually 11 different channels, 11 different verticals spanning all different topics. And I wanted to highlight for you how we think about creating new topics. We started on the top left with the main Now This News rankings by far the largest channel. It has the widest overall kind of aperture and purview. We've subsequently gone out and built a number of different focused themes around what our audience is engaging with most. And I think of Now This quite often as much as a journalism company as a data company. What I mean is each one of these channels grew out of what started as a somewhat informal monthly content audit. Our team, from a data analytics standpoint, would take a look at the videos that had the highest views, the highest engagement. They would apply some kind of meta tags to know what those videos were about, and did an analysis of what was percolating to the top. So this slide is what I often use when I talk to brands and agencies around the types of things that we do. But since we're brand storytellers, I thought I would highlight another vertical, because I said we have 11. The 11th vertical for Now This. And I bring it to you because it is a perfect example of how we use data. We're not building something for a brand only. So much to my chagrin, because I do work with brands, we started at one point Now This Weed. But Now This Weed, and unless I'm mistaken, and there's some very progressive advertisers in the audience, and we can talk about that.
If you have to. We'll talk after.
Yeah, maybe there's a Taco Bell or a Jack in the Box, or anyone who wants to do a
Cheetos,
420 activations. Q2 is just a few months away. No, so, but Now This Weed, honestly, Now This Weed was started because in that monthly content audit, so many of the videos that were percolating to the top were about cannabis. But they were not just about stoner culture or a high time. They looked at the topic of marijuana from a very now this progressive millennial issues-driven mindset. It was about incarceration rates. It was about social justice. We looked at even the business side of marijuana. I watched now this video about how so many of these businesses actually operate fully cash only. It's hard for them to go to a big national bank and necessarily go and start up a business account like a small coffee shop. And so many of the stories we were telling across the different NowThis channels ended up being about cannabis and NowThis weed. So I give it to you as an example of a proof point to show how NowThis and certainly the rest of Group 9 rely upon data, and we put our money where our mouth is in terms of growing, in this case, a media brand, a place that consumers, that a young millennial audience goes, can have trust, can get real news. And it goes without saying, we don't peddle some kind of fake news world that I think is unfortunately around so much of what's happening now. But that's the playbook that we've employed to think about growing and expanding the purview of what we do. The same data points that led to creation of a NowThis weed also allowed us to work and launch a brand like NowThis food, which we did specifically in concert with Campbell Soup Company. And again, NowThis food is not necessarily meant to just be recipe videos. It's not meant to necessarily to be a version of what you've seen from other food publishers. NowThis food goes and explores similar topics to what we know are core to our audience, and in this case are also core to Campbell's. So an example of a piece of branded content that we made with them, and I think you'll get a sense for how our storytelling method feels very quote-unquote native to the NowThis brand, but also really does a nice job for Campbell's to give themselves maybe a pat on the back they would otherwise not be able to say themselves.
Our key ingredient that we put into every batch of soup that we make here is love and hope and passion. Take Camden County residents. We try to take about 20 people every semester. We train them for 17 weeks. We give them their same certification, basic culinary skills. It's all about the soup. It's all about the love. Campbell's Soup is the biggest sponsor of Cathedral Kitchen. They have been some great partners. I mean, there's some great people just, having some rough times in their life, just because their situation is bad right now, that they're still people and we still care about them. So it's like we're family,
So I call out just two things about this. One, if you've seen a NowThis video before, you'll notice with the text on screen, the way we did some of the supers, this feels like a NowThis piece of content. It's a story. It involves, in this case, a human-centered version of what I suppose otherwise could have been a PRNewsWire.com. Campbell Soup Company partners with Cathedral Kitchen in hometown Camden for the X year. And it wouldn't have been a bad thing, and their chief philanthropy officer would have given a quotation or something like that. We went and focused it around a guy who's going and dedicating his career instead of being in a professional restaurant to working in a soup kitchen and to leading it. And so the first thing I'd say is it very much feels like a NowThis video. The second thing is I'll say is it absolutely is also a piece of brand content. And he calls out and says quite directly, this is, thanks to Campbell's, who's been a huge supporter of us. So I think it's a good example of how we think we can bring in a brand from a storytelling perspective, but do it in a way that an audience might actually go and not alone appreciate. If you look at the comments from this video, we released it at Christmas time a year ago. So many of the comments were genuinely people saying, like, good on you, Campbell's, like, thank you. And we appreciate NowThis going and bringing a story like that to us. The last thing I'll just say quickly about this is you'll notice this video is actually in square format. So we think a lot about kind of content versioning across different platforms. This actually was the Instagram cut that we used. Instagram, as I'm sure many of you know, started as a square photo service. So in some of our data testing and platform optimization, we learned that square video somewhat intuitively still works best on Instagram because that's what people are interested to see.
So when you touch 38 million people a day and you get all these really rich data points about what works, what they respond to, what they're willing to spend time with, and you can go to brands and say, what story can't you tell and aren't you telling through a 30 or 60 or 3 year typical commercial messaging, and how can we help bring insights so you can tell that story or take your assets and actually recut them, repurpose them, repackage them. It's not easy to do unless you productize that and create a system to do it at scale. It's actually quite labor-intensive to do piece by piece by piece. And we created a product last year called Socialize, rebranded Contextualize, context is king, where we've gone to market with a formula of both how it works to pull insights about not just what we know about an audience demographically or psychographically, but the things that Campbell's might not have known, that people who love Campbell's soup are also super into learning about community activism. They're entrepreneurs, they're social justice warriors, and or they're home chefs. And we can take Campbell's message and actually run it through an engine that we've created to produce content like the one you saw and like many others to make sure that their message is heard through our voice, which we know resonates with our audience in completely different and unique ways that they will still get credit for.
You are part of history tonight. Welcome to Rock the Truth.
You got family here?
No, sir.
Say hello to your mom and turn around.
They protect our country so we can have a country. And to that, I say, all right, all right, all right.
I always is fun, and I'll say, this is a piece of Now This content in your feed. Now This Entertainment, which is the channel that we produced it and distributed out of, does stuff like this all the time. And I think it's important to highlight when we think about a really good ad product or a native ad unit, it's got to start with something that, in fact, the editorial team did first. And I remember seeing this as a consumer even of Now This. We would be doing videos all the time, right? Kind of Now This style, the Netflix just released this trailer for Daredevil, fight scene, fight scene, fight scene. And then go check it out. It wasn't unpaid, that's just our editorial team finding what they thought was a cool new show. So we leveraged that exact same storytelling format. We had some kind of persistent call to actions and things like that to drive people to tune in. What was striking to me about this was when you compare how well our performance on Now This Entertainment did against The Rock. He's the host, he has, if you look at this at the time, almost 60 million followers on Facebook, and he did almost 763,000 views of the video, which is pretty good. We had 2.3 million followers at the time, and it did 4.3 million views. Now you might say, okay, but hold on, Christian. You guys were working in a paid partnership with Spike. You leveraged paid media. And I don't know, in all honesty, whether they did from The Rock's handle. So from an apples-to-apples comparison, one way to compare it, then, is to look at the share rate. So The Rock, with his 700,000 views or so, did 3,000-plus shares. His share rate, straight-line division, was 0.47, which is actually quite high. When you look at the same apples-to-apples comparison with the Now This video, paid or unpaid, on our 4.3 million views, we did over 40,000 shares, which is a share rate of almost 1%, 2x what The Rock, who's the host of the show, saw on his. 1%, almost 1% of people who viewed this content ended up clicking share and broadcasting it to all of their friends. And it's, again, because this is something that feels like a Now This video. And we tag it, we mention it with Spike, and there's a pretty clear text on screen, call to action about going to check it out. But I think that, to me, is what makes this a very powerful model, and it makes it different from if they had just bought from us, X million impressions of their piece.
Another one that we're super proud of is some work we just did with Herbal Essences, where they came to us with a commercial asset about changing your hair, and how difficult it is.
Changing my hair, changed how my
hair you can feel.
A few years ago.
Commercial content, it's great. It looks better when it speaks to the audience, packaged in a tone of voice that they're more familiar with, they're more receptive to in their feed. They can play with the sound off. We know the right font to use. We know the right scene to put on. We know the right length that it should be cut to. And we also know that that should look and work differently on Facebook than it should on Twitter, than it should on Instagram, etc. And while these stats are fantastic, what was most powerful were their brand health metrics. First consideration, branding intent through the roof. While that was not through the roof, ad recall was flat because nobody saw this as advertising, even though it very much was. So in finding new ways to help advertisers tell their story commercially in a modern way, we've found a lot of success with these brands, with the platforms, and with new forms and formats that are coming up every single day. And another song that you might have heard about six or seven times this week will be the soundtrack for a little bit more of our branded work that we've been up to this past year.
Hi, honey, I'm home. This isn't our home.
No, this is set. This is a mic over here.
All right, Marco, so what's the plan?
Everybody's watching this viral video
with the Gary Best advertisement, right? You like a drug to me, a luxury, my sugar
and gold. I want the good life every good night, you're a hot one to hold. Have it on Instagram like this.
She's so fearless, independent, and capable.
Sometimes I find inspiration in the most unexpected places.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, yeah. I feel really good.
We're in it because of the impact. What they're doing is going to change the entire world.
Conclusion. Amazing adventure.
Yep.
Let's do it again.
Boom.
So a couple last things, where we're going next. Some of you guys know Josh. Hopefully you made it to the party last night. Hopefully you got into the party last night. If you didn't, I apologize. We acquired the guys at Josh sometime in October, November, actually like a month after I started. And what was most amazing about it was we had a partnership established with them over the past year to create content working with people like Sarah Silverman, partnering them with Bernie Sanders, putting them on the campaign trail to cover the election in a different way, working with them and the NowThis editorial team in the NHL to tell the story of the Las Vegas Golden Knights, who are the new expansion team that just started this season in Vegas, to tell the story of how a team comes together in the community to form a bond. And while we're out there, the shooting happened, and we're embedded out there with these guys who never played together, all just moved to Vegas, and we're in the midst of this incredible tragedy, that they then wanted to play some part in trying to help the community heal while they were trying to find their way together as a team. We created this series called Home Team. It was debuted on Facebook Watch, one of the 24 shows that we debuted this past fall. I encourage you to watch it because it opened up a new way of stories that we didn't plan on telling, but actually gave way to a new franchise called NowThis Sports that tells very much the stories behind the stories. Of what athletes of all types, professional and amateur otherwise, are doing in their communities, helping other people in society in different ways. And we're really excited to have the Josh guys help up-level some of our storytelling content with the access to talent and writing and production they have in Hollywood that just kind of changes the face of what we produce. And what we're most excited about most recently is our first linear show that we're going to launch with Animal Planet in March called Dodo Heroes. So of the 24 shows that we launch on Facebook Watch, and whether they're here or not, I think I can tell you we're the number one publisher on Facebook Watch, one of them is called Comeback Kids, which tells you about animals who've been rehabilitated and brought back into society in ways that are just terrible, but the humanity and the story behind them, the relationships that people have with these animals just does such good in the world, and it resonates so well with audiences of all types. I mean, overnight did a million views in the first episode, and we got a call to greenlight the second series. Immediately. From that we said, what if we told the longer form narrative? What if we did hour-long, six episodes, pitch it to Discovery, who's one of our investors, to give them a new format for programming around the planet, that they're not just going to run on linear, they're going to run every platform. And every platform in a slightly different way. Different on VOD than it is on Snap, than it is on Facebook, because it's content for someone, for everyone. Everyone is not going to watch this on every single platform. But everyone will watch it in some unique way, and it's a story that we feel we can tell really richly across all these platforms. So it's coming out in a couple of months, I think right around South by premieres, and we're incredibly excited for it and the potential for developing more programming across platforms like that. We could leave you with 5 points. And I wouldn't say this is our formula, this is our blueprint, this is our mantra, but it is what we believe. Data is just people in disguise. We see so much of it every single day that we understand who people are, we understand what makes them tick, we understand what they're going to want to see more of, what they're going to see less of. So we can program to them, we can bring advertising to them, we can bring them stories in really unique ways to get them to participate, to take action, to be entertained and be informed. But above all, virality is not a strategy because the things that are one-hit wonders are not going to be replicable. We learn from the things that don't work So we stop repeating our mistakes and we just continue to raise the floor and produce better and better content. And it's why we've been so successful on the platforms and why we've been so successful with the partners and the advertisers that we've worked with.
I mentioned testing and how it's important for us to learn what works and doesn't. So relentlessly testing is an important part of everything we do. Even now, the Now This text on screen that seems like it's somewhat familiar and baked in is always being tweaked. And that's because the rules will keep changing. There are always going to be new algorithms, new platforms, new ways of people consuming content. And so we have to stay ahead of that. That is very much a part of the Group 9 ethos, always to be moving and moving quickly. And we mentioned this, I really believe that what makes a portfolio of media properties like Group 9 powerful is that we have content for somebody, not for everybody, but when you add up all of those somebody, it is everybody. You look at the four different focuses we have, I think there is a part of it which can speak to any interest you might have across the whole portfolio. So thank you again,
guys.